Alright, Shalom. I'm gonna give all praises. Yahweh Ba'asham, Yahweh Shai. Double honor to the Apostle Elazar, great men stood that rule well. Salutations unto all the brothers around the world, pushing this word in truth and sincerity. Alright? I am Amawan from the Trinidad Great Millstone Camp. Right? I want to do a video on proving that the so-called Negroes, the Latinos and the Native Americans, they are the children of the Most High and the Son. Yahweh, the Heavenly Father name is Yahweh, and His only begotten Son's name is Yahweh Shai. And when Yahweh Shai was on the earth, he was not so-called cracker. He was not cracker. He was not Edomite. He was not so-called white man. He was a so-called if he was walking the earth today, they would have called him a so-called Negro. They would have called him a so-called Negro. He wasn't a so-called white boy. He was not a white boy. Right? That is one thing I have to hear it, proving that, hey, we is them people now. We are those people and we are going to. What? What is the real proof? You are real hardcore proof. Who them people really is on the earth today? Hey, you have to go to Deuteronomy 28 chapter. That is concrete proof. That is undebatable proof that we is them people. Undebatable. So for any younger brothers who watching this video at any time, you know, if you're now coming into this thing, Deuteronomy 28 chapter is there, this thing. Two verses. But when I now coming into it, that was the verse, that was one of the verses I read. And I was like, wait, this thing real, it's real. No. What I understand too is, one of the things I understand, that this was supposed to happen. But before, I will explain why I say it was supposed to happen later. But before the curses, it have the blessings. It have the blessings, and then it had the curses. The curses surpass the blessings by far. And I will show you them curses apply to the so-called Negroes, the Latinos, and the Native American people today. The Caribbean, the Arawaks down here also. Right? It says, this Deuteronomy 28 chapter, out of the Holy Bible, the Holy King James Version of the Bible. KJV, see? King James Version. The Holy Bible, which all your so-called pastors don't friggin' read. He don't take time to explain to all you, so he can't be all in here. I read the blessings first, and then I read the curses. This is Moses talking to the children of Israel, right? Deuteronomy 28, chapter 1, right? I mean verse 1, so like here. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy power, to observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy power will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. So you see what Moses is saying. If you listen to the Most High, you will put we up on high, right? and all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of Yahweh thy power. Hear what it says. It says, blessed shalt thou be in the city, and blessed shalt thou be in the field. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy ground, and the fruit of thy cattle, in the increase of thy kind, and the flocks of thy sheep. So we'll have everything we desire, the fruit of your body will just be true, and then we'll be blessed. The fruit of your ground, wherever we put our hand to, that will be blessed. The fruit of your cattle, the flocks, anything, the increase of everything will be blessed. Blessed shall thy basket and thy blessed shall be thy basket and thy store. Blessed shall thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shall thou be when thou goest out. Yahweh Yahushai shall cause thine enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. They shall come up against thee one way and flee before thee seven ways. So anybody who did come up against thee, they will come one way and they will just be beaten to pieces. If we did keep all the laws of the Most High said to them. The Lord shall command a blessing upon thee in thy storehouses and in all that thou settest thy hand unto, and he shall bless thee in the land which the Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahushai giveth. And the Lord shall establish thee an holy people unto himself, as he hath sworn unto thee. If thou shalt keep the commandments of Yahweh and walk in his ways, and all the people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of Yahweh, and they shall be afraid of thee. And Yahweh shall make thee plenteous in goods, in the fruit of thy body, and in the fruit of thy cattle, and in the fruit of thy ground, and in the land which Yahweh sware unto thy fathers to give thee. See, Yahweh shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heaven, to give the rain unto thy land in his season, and bless all the work of thy hand, and thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. I'll read from verse 13, right? I'll jump into 15. It says, but it shall come to pass, meaning it will not come to pass, if thou will not hearken unto the voice of Yahweh Shai, thy power, to observe and to do all his commandments and his statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Now I'm about to read curses, which all are we under right now, the whole nation under. It don't matter if it's that Jake who have $6 billion, because that Jake's our money, that's some rich Jake. From all the tribes, from Judah, that's some in Benjamin have this big shop. Don't matter. We still servants. And they go realize that, because the Most High getting ready to show his hand just now. But these are the curses, right? These are the curses I'm about to read. The curses stem from verse 16 to verse 68. The blessings is just from verse 2 to verse 14. Curses. I just show you how much curses we under. The curses stem from verse 16 to 68. You are not real curses. And I'm about to, I'm going to show you this. These curses did come upon us. Now, this is Daniel, chapter 9, verse 11. It says, yea, this is Daniel, it says, yea, all Israel have transgressed thy law. What law is that? The law written And he will explain himself. Even by departing, because this Israel totally just forget everything and just depart from the whole world, which is the so-called Negroes, the Latinos, and the Native American people. That they might not observe thy voice. Therefore the curse is poured upon us. And the oath, it was an oath. The Most High make it an oath. That if we did depart that oath, he made that oath. I'm gonna look up the meaning of the word oath. I know no set up in app camera and all kind of thing. So I'm gonna look it up on my TV. Because I'm taping this from my tablet. One entitled triumph, the other entitled. So the Most High make it an oath that if we should depart from his law, and we did, because Daniel recited it there, right? He said Israel departed, right? Let's know that. 1 second. Oath, right? Is a solemn promise. You see that? The word oath is a solemn promise, often invoking a divine witness regarding one's future action or behavior. A profane or offensive expression used to express anger and other strong emotions. So you see what it is? It's a solemn promise. And the first thing, a solemn promise. So hey, that was a promise from the Most High. The Lord is not slack concerning his promises, as some men call slackness. Matter of fact, let me get it. So you see, it's an oath the Most High made. Oath, right? That if we should leave the law, leave off the law, go do we something. No. In a little bit I go and read the curses what we are now right now. But let's just read this. So he says a solemn promise, right? The 2 Peter chapter 3 and 9. It says, the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, being slack, as some men count slackness, but is long suffering to us. So what I'm just pulling up is that the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, right? And if it is, the word oath is a solemn promise, eh? Understand? So let's prove it. Watch this. And the oath that is written in the law of Moses, the servant of the Most High, because we have sinned against him. So because we sinned against the Most High, that curse, the curses which I am about to read, they were sealed. That weaves them. And he had confirmed his words which he spake against us and against our judges that judged us by bringing upon us a great evil. For under the whole heaven had not been done as had been done upon Jerusalem. under the whole heaven. The whole world never see nothing, nothing happen, sir. The whole earth, it just, they never see.